everybody. It is now 5:30, which means it's time for Danganronpa V3 Killing Harmony. So, last time we let off, we got four random pieces of junk. But they weren't just any kind of junk. They were actually useful items that allowed us to get into new places. We unlocked the Ultimate Tennis Pros Lab, Maki's Lab. She claims to be the ultimate child caregiver. I really don't think that's true. We unlocked Gonta's Lab, the ultimate entomologist. My apologies. We unlocked Kurumi's Lab, which is the ultimate maid's. We unlocked a casino and some love hotel. I'm very confused. All the characters are high school students. Let's see, what else did we unlock? We unlocked the pool. And what else did we unlock? We found some weird flashlight thing, which Andy ran off with. Not sure what it does. And then what else? We found the ultimate mages. Or ultimate magician's lab. So, it'll be interesting to see where we go from here. Let's continue. Oh, I just noticed there's a piano on top of the building. Aw, that's a reminder of Kaede. Aw, that's sweet. Okay, so we already talked with everyone here. There wasn't really much else that I could see with my... Oh, actually, school building window. We might have to look at that. This window must be one of the school buildings. I remember all of the windows being sealed off, but this window in particular looks like a normal window. What room does it belong to?
Anyone can peep through that window!
Peep? Who would do that?
I heard degenerate males get more turned on by girls in swimsuits than by girls who are naked. And they go bonkers over boomers we wear. Over our panties that we wear over our privates.
Degenerate male!
What are girls supposed to do against the filthy desires of degenerate males?
No.
I think you may be overreacting a little.
Oh, Kibo, are you a degenerate male or girl? Which is it?
Good question. I've honestly never thought about it before. Really? How interesting. I suppose I did assume he was a he, but Kibo is a robot, so... I suppose this is all for the pool area. I still have other places to investigate. Okay, so... Would you like to leave? Yes, I'm pretty sure I'd have searched everything everywhere.
Yeah!
Oh, Angie!
Yahoo! Found you, sweetie!
Oh!
I didn't know you were here! I've been looking for you everywhere!
Ah, Angie! Did you find out anything about the flashlight?
Yep, I finally figured it out! It seems like R2R wants us to gather in the gym for an explanation!
Bye,
Yonara! I don't have time! You don't have time to relax now! Bye, Yonara!
If Atua is going to explain it to us, I'm guessing she didn't figure it out. But in any case, I should go to the gym. Nope, we're just being transported. Nope, not transported. Okay. So let's go. What it could be. Can I feel... Personally, I feel like it's just going to be like one of those special light things. Like a UV light, in a sense. I feel like that's all it's going to be. But this is a Danganronpa game and nothing is ever quite what it seems. So who knows what it could actually be. Let's see what Atua has to say about it. Atua, what do you know about a flashlight?
Optimus, bow ahead, Inferno, R2O.
Yes.
You're a real pain in the ass. You know that? Just tell us what you're fucking what.
Nothing.
Alrighty there, check this out.
What's the matter?
That is a peculiar looking flashlight. So what of it?
I don't know what it is either. I expected it pretty good. But in the end, I couldn't figure it out.
Thanks, Angie.
Huh?
You couldn't.
Okay, fine.
So I asked someone for help.
Could it be?
You don't mean.
No! Why would you ask Monokuma?
Leave it to Monokuma!
If something has you worried, just let Monokuma take care of it. If you don't know something, I'll tell you. If you need help, I'll help you out. If you don't like something, I'll fix it. So don't get rid of it. Please don't get rid of me.
Very bad for the lady who act like that prey on you.
Huh? Huh? Do you know that from personal experience?
Yoo-hoo!
Tell us, Monokuma, what is this flashlight?
Yeah?
Why, that's a flashback light!
Uh-huh. A flashback light.
Huh?
Flashback!
Yeah, nice.
Light! That flashlight doesn't shed light on darkness! It sheds light on your lost memories! What?
Right. Lost memories?
You guys seem concerned that you couldn't remember how you came to this school! But if you use that flashback light, you can remember everything!
And it was just sitting in the chest for us to find.
How is this a trap?
Will it imprint false memories into us?
Huh?
What? With this light? So it's your fault we don't remember when we were kidnapped, huh?
May I?
What did you do to us and how did you steal our memories away?
And another.
Maybe if you use the flashback light, you'll be able to remember that too.
This is stupid.
I don't believe it. No way this flashlight will recover our memories.
I bet there were a lot of naysayers and skeptics when the telephone was invented, too. For your information, the flashback light can treat various symptoms of memory loss. The light it emits stimulates the basal ganglia and hippocampus. Not just that, but physical. I didn't realize how boring it would be to explain. Basically, it works like that.
Hey! Don't just give up on explaining after a single sentence!
What should we do?
So, what should we do?
What should we do? You mean should we not use the flashlight?
No.
No way! I refuse! It reeks of fishiness!
Hmm.
Yeah. Gunther no can believe flashlight can bring back memory.
Well,
why not ask someone who knows machines? We got the ultimate inventor right here.
Aww.
Yup, all a bunch of fucking ultimate dumbasses. No fucking way that thing can treat amnesia. Then again, these aren't exactly normal circumstances.
So in such an uncanny environment as this, common sense has no place.
Well, I mean, there are those neuralizers things. The flashy things for Men in Black.
Well...
Why are you talking about a movie? This is real life.
I guess.
Yeah, you're right. Sorry.
I don't like that.
I don't think we should do it. I'm scared it might cause some weird side effects. Yeah. I'm worried about how it'll affect my magic. Is that flashlight going to be the cause of the second murder?
All of you.
Has everyone spoken? If we're in a court, I will consent as well.
Yeah.
What about you, Suichi? I have not heard you say anything yet.
Yes, that's it.
Huh?
I just said something.
What? I...
Why?
All right, then it's decided. Let's use it. Kata, what?
What?
Huh? Who decided that? We were all saying how dangerous it sounds.
Jeez, you guys are way too cautious. I mean, I understand why. We're in such a weird situation after all.
But you know...
But we can't win by just running away all the time.
What?
Listen up.
If you want to win, you've got to be a little reckless sometimes. If we can't face this danger, there's no way we'll be able to defeat Monokuma.
Well, aren't you confident? But you've no idea how you're supposed to win, do you?
Yeah, I've got no clue, but still. If you want to win, you gotta make a stand somewhere, or you'll never move forward. If we run away, our kids will grow up to be the kind of people who run away from things like this.
I don't understand.
Huh? What are you talking about?
No.
If you still want to run away, then go ahead. I won't stop you or blame you.
Okay.
Okay, fine. Then, let's go.
Huh? What's wrong, everyone?
Are we going?
I'm staying! After hearing that degenerate speech, running away would just frustrate me. Gonta also stay, is what two gentlemen would probably do.
100%.
I also agree with Kato. Our defeat is 100% assured unless we stand up to this. That's how I feel, deep inside, just a whisper.
You hear it in your ghost. I'm pretty sure robots don't have ghosts, though.
That's not fun.
Leave me alone.
I shall stay as well. I suspect you will be able to observe something most interesting.
On your knees!
If anything happens to me, y'all better beg my fans, the world, and humanity for forgiveness.
Alright. So, what are you gonna do, sweetie?
I'll stay behind too.
Got it.
Alright.
Right?
I'll stay too. So, what if it might cause some weird side effects? That's no big deal.
It seems
everyone agrees with Kaito. Very well, I shall follow suit.
Now it's decided. Who will we do?
Woohoo!
Then I'm gonna turn it on!
Yeah.
Yes, please.
Hello.
At the moment that Angie flicked on the light, the world warped.
Interesting. A lightning bolt in my mind shattered my consciousness like shrapnel. Like a video in fast forward, scenes played out in the back of my head. When the pieces of my psyche had gathered together again. I remember now. I was running away. I had been running away this entire time. From the ultimate hunt. Those of us with ultimate talents were hunted down. I wasn't safe anywhere. So is this like the world being afraid of the most despair-inducing, like, traumatic, most devastating event, tragic event in human history? Is this them, like, trying to prevent that from happening again? Is this the normal people revolting against the Ultimates? Eventually, I had no place else to run. I was cornered, and to escape from the Ultimate Hunt, I threw away my Ultimate Talent to live life as a normal high school student. By erasing my talent and my memories, I no longer had any reason to be hunted. If I didn't do what I did, I would have been captured a fate worse than death. And so I chose. I chose to gamble on a new technology developed in a particular facility. This looks familiar. Technology that can put your memories to sleep by controlling your brainwaves. Are we in a simulation? I used it to hibernate all memories relating to my talent. Yes, I remember everything now. In order to escape the ultimate hunt, I erased my own memory.
Hold on.
Wait, did you say ultimate hunt?
Huh?
Really?
You guys too? So, it wasn't just me getting chased down in this ultimate hunt?
I do not agree.
Yes, you were not the only one. We were being chased as well. We all looked around at one another, each of us with the same shocked expression. What Kurumi said was true. We were all the same. We were all running from the ultimate hunt.
In other words,
all of us here were being chased by the ultimate hunt. What on earth does that mean? Oh, wait! Can someone tell me what that is? I can't seem to remember. What is the ultimate hunt?
Jeez,
how could you forget something so important? Alright guys, the ultimate hunt is...
What?
Huh? What was it? Why can't I remember? I can't either. I suddenly realized I could not remember any important details of the ultimate hunt.
How?
It's no use. I can't remember either. I can only remember being chased. I can't remember anything else at all. Yeah, no matter how hard I try, I can't seem to remember.
I don't want to live. I want to die with everyone else.
What? What was that? I want to die with everyone else? I remember saying that, but why did I say it? It's no use. I can't remember either.
Damn it!
This feels gross, like a shit that won't fully squeeze out.
However,
even if you can't remember, we should still be able to figure something out.
Huh?
What do you mean? If we were all running from the ultimate hunt, then why are we in prison, team?
Why?
Huh? Why?
Could
the reason be that we were caught by the ultimate hunt? Caught by the ultimate hunt. You mean we tried to escape by erasing our memories, but they found us anyway. And subsequently, we were captured as part of this ultimate hunt.
You know.
Then this killing game is.
Yeah. It might be the work of the ultimate hunt.
Let's see.
If that is so, then I am all the more concerned about this ultimate hunt.
But,
how disappointing. No one can remember anything. What a disappointment.
Piece of shit.
Quit laughing about this, you little shit.
It seems
losing him made a far bigger impact than we expected.
Huh?
Him?
Yes.
Rantoro, he seemed to know more than he let on. Hey, I have a question. This might sound a little weird, but does the term ultimate hunt ring a bell for anyone?
Oh,
I do sort of remember him saying something like that.
Hmm.
Oh, my mother, Mystery Man said that, huh?
But
then, why did only Rantaro remember the ultimate hunt?
Listen.
There is no point discussing that now. After all, he is already dead. But if you truly wish to hear his words, I can perform a seance for you.
Stop it! Don't bring up weird stuff like that! And why are you acting all girly all of a sudden? Well, Kuma, hi!
Yep, death can be real heartless!
Says the root of all evil.
Looks like you guys safely got your memory back.
What the hell is going on, you stupid ass bear? This Oliver the Hunt makes no goddamn sense.
Looks like your sealed memories are more stubborn than I thought. Just one use of the flashback light wasn't enough to restore all of your memories.
You got me.
You're such a terrible liar. You totally did that on purpose.
Well...
What connection do you have with the Ultimate Hunt?
I can't reveal that. Regardless of my true identity, my goal is crystal clear. And that is to make you guys participate in the killing game. That is my only desire.
The killing game. That's what it always comes back to.
You gotta be kidding me!
What? Killing game? I will never do that ever again!
That's right.
We just gotta work together. If we cooperate, we'll make it out of here alive. Just like a certain someone said. Kaede. But I believe cooperating with each other is the most logical course of action. I'm sorry. Why are you sleeping?
Whoa.
What?
Hey, Kokichi. We're having a serious conversation here.
And is it written somewhere that I have to take serious conversations seriously? Quit acting so immature! I'm a teenager, so duh, I'm immature. Aren't you guys forgetting Daku age?
What is it?
But I don't have a biological age!
Ah.
Don't worry about it, Kibo. I'm just talking to the humans right now.
So?
What were we talking about again? Something about working together to escape, right? So you are listening, you horrible degenerate!
See?
We don't have to work together, though. Let's just ask how we can get out. If we ask Monokuma, he'll say the only way is to win the killing game. We're not gonna ask Monokuma. We're gonna ask the mastermind among us.
Huh?
What?
Why, you?
Are you already going senile? I thought we agreed there is no mastermind. Oh yeah, we did, didn't we? If we tried to sniff out a mastermind again, we'd just repeat Kaede's screw up. You better quit messing around!
Huh?
You think I'm messing around right now?
Oh man,
you really don't get it. I'm trying to get this through to everyone. If you keep saying all this uplifting stuff about working together and cooperating, then you can expect to receive some painful retaliation. Got it?
Wait!
What are you suggesting, Kokichi?
That's enough!
That's enough! I'm gonna slug him!
Whoa!
He's gonna punch me! I gotta make a break for it! Kokichi said his piece and then dashed as fast as he could out of the room. Damn, he's fast!
Sheesh.
Jeez, what a strange guy.
Jeez.
He just provokes people and never says anything from the heart. He's always messing around and making fun of those around him.
How can he say such insensitive things when we're trying so hard to survive?
It's like he doesn't even want to survive. No, I guess I'm no different.
Huh?
What?
In other words,
I don't plan to survive until the end. I'm killing myself right now. Ryoma. You do not plan to survive. What that mean?
He has mentioned that before, that he has no reason to live.
Mm-hmm.
He doesn't have a reason to live.
Poor Ryoma.
It seems he's got a more tragic past than even we could begin to imagine.
I mean...
Yeah. But the ultimate tennis pro shouldn't be saying such cowardly stuff.
What are you saying?
Perhaps we should relax over a meal. Everyone, could you please tell me your favorite foods and beverages?
Huh?
Huh? You're gonna whip something up? Kurumi, are you like the perfect mom?
After we finished the meal that Kurumi prepared for us, we decided to return to our rooms. Is it soon free time? There are hidden Monokumas around the Ultimate Academy. Maybe you've already seen one. You can collect hidden Monokumas by investigating them. Your collection will be displayed on the shelf in this room, so get busy filling it. They look fun to look at when you want to take a break from everything. Anyway, what is the ultimate hunt? It's still bothering me. And why did Rantaro know? Did Rantaro get blasted with, like, the wrong, flashlights? But I suppose I won't get anywhere thinking about it by myself. Time for action.
All right.
There's still some time left today. I need to think of a plan. Free time. All right, let us save first. All right, now let's go and get some stuff from the store so we can do some. Can actually get somewhere with some friendship fragments. Especially because I got rid of my one with Ryoma already. It was annoying. I mean,
granted it was one, but it,
you know, it still, you know, kind of sucks. Ah, stupid. Let's see, who shall we talk with? Let's see what stuff we get first. New store. So let's get some coin. We have a lot of coins. Gyoza in the shape of a face, we already had that. Pillow of admiration. Interesting. Perfect laser gun. Again, more stuff for Kaito. Or at least I think it's cool. Fully automated saved ice machine. That's cool. Everywhere parasol. I can go a bit more than that. Baba tea. Rice toy blocks. Ooh, lucky chance we get another item. Autumn colored scarf. Rock hard ice cream. Bunny apples. Look, these are actually really cute. Sketchbook. Ultimate, that's definitely for the hardest. And flame thunder. Jelly balls. And lucky chance, we get another auto-colored scarf. We're getting a lot of scarves. Sparkly sheet. And lucky chance, another item. Robot orb. Wow, I wonder who that could be for. Three-lighted lunchbox. Workout clothes. That would be for, Tenko. I'm a picture book artist. Probably for the ultimate artist. And a hand mirror. Hand-knit sweater. Tiny blanket.
animals. Art mannequin. Again, another thing for Angie. God of Man's Passion. Not sure who that would go for. Or bunny apples. Sheer coat uniform. Latest Machines Part Catalog. Steel glasses case. And actually, now that I think about it, the steel glasses case might go for Gonto, because he does wear glasses. It would help. Okay, so that's everything. That's all our coins. So we got a lot of stuff. But I'm not quite sure if we go there. A chic autumn-colored scarf that can be used by men, women, and robots. It's very trendy and fashionable and accent to any outfit. Huh. An animal picture book for preschool kids. For some reason, bears are not featured in it. Okay. There's not really anyone too worried about their appearance, so I'm not sure who that could go for. Sparkly sheet. That would be for a robot. Toy blocks made out of rice, they're safe for babies to put in their mouth, but they'll go bad if they aren't eaten right away. Perfect laser gun. Gun of Man's Passion, a model of an imaginary weapon. It's powerful, but it only a worthy man may fire it. Embrace it to feel a man's fantasy. You can give it away, but something good might happen if you keep it. So I feel that would go for the ultimate cosplayer. And saved fully automated shaped ice machine. Alright, let's look at our list of people and what their likes and dislikes are. Let's see if we can get one. So Kato, he likes houseplants. Ultimate astronaut, we got plenty of space related stuff we could give him. Ryoma, Russian blues. Okay, so we like Russian stuff. Interesting. Rantaro's dead. Gunter would like bug related. Kokichi likes sodas. Kurikyu likes straw ropes. Weird. He dislikes air conditioning. Kibo is anything basically remotely robot related. Kurumi is anything cleaning. Himiko is magic based things. Maki, I'm not really sure what Maki would get. What to give Maki. Tenko, I'm just gonna ignore Tenko. I don't like Tenko. Tsumugi would be anything cosplay related. Angie is everything art related. Or possibly delicious. And Mew would be anything inventory. So I'm gonna try the robot, the machine part catalog, or Mew. Hopefully that'll get us somewhere useful. So I'm just gonna save there. Let's go find out where is Mew right now. There we go. Mew is right on the second floor. Let's go to her. What the fuck? Is that what that flashlight? Flashback light. You can't just mess with someone's memory using light. Should I hang out with you for a while? Sure! If Mami Kuma can do it, then this gorgeous girl genius, Mew Iruma, can do it too. I'm gonna make myself one. I'm gonna make one myself. Why don't we just flash the flashlight again? I spent some time helping you make a flashback light. Somehow ended up growing a little closer to Mew. Would you like to give Mew a present? Definitely. Let's give her the latest parts catalog. I feel like she would like that. Given that she is such an adventurer, I feel like she would like that, so give?
Damn, Luigi, you actually brought me something nice. I bet I'll show you an invention of mine. I bet you're so thankful you're about to cry.
What?
Huh? You're not interested? Why?
Hey, Luigi!
Hey, alright, Luigi, you ready?
Huh?
Ready.
What was that?
Huh? Don't look at me like I just blew up a dove with a rocket launcher. I, Mew Iruma, the gorgeous girl genius, am gonna devote my time to you. And you'll entertain me in return, right? You'll leave me 100% satisfied, right?
Huh?
I don't know about that.
Huh?
Huh? You said you invited me without making any plans?
You mother...
Typical. When men see the heat I'm packing, they get all nervous and stiff. But since you got me in a good mood, alright, I'll show you my inventions. Follow me! Without waiting for my answer, you strutted towards your lab. Oh yeah, we haven't really seen you inside of her lab. Ta-da! Here we are, new Iruma's research lab. I know that, you brought me.
Booyah!
Now, the first invention I'll show you is this. What is that? What is this, a sensor? Wow, you actually figured out it's a sensor, but can you guess what kind of sensor?
No.
I don't know. That's what I thought. I call this baby the hookup counter.
Huh?
Hookup counter.
Toy.
It counts how many people you fucked, or how many have fucked you. Don't point that at me. Too late. Let's see the results, Sammy. No. Fucking way! Are you kidding me? What did it say? What did it say? Now, onto the next dimension. You held out a machine that looked like an arm with a boxing glove on the fist. What is this? Auto puncher that punches you for telling terrible dirty jokes.
Huh?
Why is the name so literal? Who cares? I'm not too lazy to think of a name. I'm constantly cranking out new inventions. Can't expect me to name them all.
Ha,
I mean,
virgin.
Do you name each of your little dudes after you blast them into a tissue? You got punched pretty hard. Is she okay? She's... That was sudden. Still though, that was a good punch. I guess she's fine. Alright, sorry to get your fun short, but I've got one more invention to show. What is it this time? What is it this time? This looks like a ray gun from a science fiction movie. This baby will teleport underwear in a flash. I call it the Goen Commando Gun.
Huh?
What? Just point this light at a pair of underwear and you can send it anywhere you want. What do you think? Cool shit, right?
Huh?
Huh? What? You can teleport objects?
Out of my way!
Not all objects, just underwear. Just underwear. She's wasting this incredible technology on underwear. What do you think? Bow before my formidable talent. I don't know what to say. This is all very odd.
What?
What? Don't look at me like that with those cold eyes. I just wanted to show this stuff to you. Uh-oh, did I upset her?
No.
No, it's really creative. Really good stuff. Really?
Okay.
Yeah, I think it's good that you have so much fun with your inventions. Yeah, I think so. That makes me happy. Yeah, but my inventions are...
I fucking
My inventions are always awesome without even saying it. But even geniuses like to be praised. You seem to understand that pretty well. You know, you're pretty alright. I'll treat you real good from now on. Just make sure my techniques doesn't blow your mind too hard. You'll treat me good, so you're not gonna test anything on me, right? Yes! Friendship Fragment! Music Poker has been updated.
Woo! Let's see what the update gave us about it. My brain feeling a little bit scrambled, I return to my room. Like there's still some time left. Alright. Let's see what that friendship fragment is. After I save. Now, even if I'm not fully doing all of the plot lines and stuff for the free time, there, always with these games, there is a, after you beat the game, there's this, mode where you literally all it is basically just open free time with the person. So you can get to go through their entire thing by yourself without worrying about the constant time limits and everything. So that is nice. Let's see, what do you think so? The inventions Mew shows off are all incredible, but it's so absurd that they seem like a waste of technology. She seemed to have taken a liking to me after I supported her eccentric inventing habit. Alright, so let's see, who should we go for next? You know what? Kibo, let's see what you gotta say. Where is Kibo? Kibo is in the courtyard. Oh, no, he's here in the building. Door. Let's talk to the robot. Kibo should be in his room. Is that one? Yeah, that one. There's an area in their school that's closed off. It seems there are other hidden rooms as well. So to hang out with Kibo for a while. Yes!
Yes.
Alright, then let's explore this school together. Kibo and I spent some time exploring the grounds. Kibo and I grew a little closer to get today. Would you like to give Kibo a present?
Yes!
We got so many things that we could give Kibo. I'm going to give him... I'm a picture book artist. An electronic device that is equipped with an AI to produce a new picture book every time it's turned on. Great for kids who love hearing bedtime stories. Oh, so that's go to Maki then. I still don't know who the metronome would go to. Let's see. We could give him the robot oil, but don't know if we want to give him. We got... Screw it. Let's give him the robot arm. We can always go back and get more.
Thank you very much.
This is quite a practical gift. Thank you.
Listen closely.
Please don't get the wrong impression. I'm happy because this gift is so practical. Under the different circumstances, this gift could be considered an act of robophobia. Since you have come to speak to me, I can only assume you've taken part in some sort of interest in me.
Well,
you are a robot after all.
I understand.
Indeed, curiosity is a very useful human quality. Very well, I shall humor you. I feel as though he's talking down to me a little.
Well then.
So first, I will explain my functions. As a robot, I'm somewhat extraordinary compared to you.
But
I remember you saying something about having the strength of an old person. True, but considering the tragedy that occurred during trial production, it was a logical design choice.
Well then.
Now first, is my vision accurate? I have 20/13 vision. Impressive, no?
Really?
You think so? I believe that's pretty normal.
Why?
What are you talking about? Over 50% of high school students have less than 20/20 vision. But no matter what, my visual acuity will always be 20/13. If it got any worse, I suppose that would count as a malfunction.
Listen closely.
My next function will surprise you. Suichi, raise your hand. Please raise your hand.
Huh?
Huh? My what?
please.
I want you to put your hand in front of my mouth. Like this? What the hell is this? Lukewarm breath grazed across my hand. Well, Kibo is a robot, so maybe not breath.
How about this?
How about that? In addition, my warm breath also functions as a dryer. I see.
Please wait.
Nada, you can't be surprised just yet, okay? Case in point, my hand can turn into a multi-tool. With both hands, I have 20 tools at my disposal. My fingers can detect wafting of robots and even distinguish between different scents. I also have a music player for when I'm bored. I can even play tapes and records. Neat, huh? I'm still thinking about how weird your breath felt. I don't know about your other functions. Don't be too surprised. After all, I am the ultimate robot. Oh, we actually get dialogue choices.
Let's go with... Yeah, amazing.
Okay. Yeah, amazing.
Well, of course.
Right, I am Professor Adabashi's masterpiece after all. The professor's technology has given me the functions to support a life of comfort. A life of comfort? I see, that makes sense.
But...
However...
I...
My greatest attribute is not actually a function at all.
Huh?
It isn't.
That's...
You can't tell what it is?
How about this?
It's my compact, lightweight design that makes my various functions possible. This is what truly drives Professor Adabashi's technological revolution. Well, now do you understand just how amazing I am? I don't know how to respond to all this boasting. Maybe someone like me would really appreciate his mechanics. Yeah, Friendship Fragments! Woo! And now I believe it goes to nighttime. Q and I parted ways and I returned to my room. Why is it just Monodon? Wait a minute. Oh, no. No, that's just a shadow covering the one. Oh, that's Angie's doll.
This is an official announcement.
Official announcement from the Ultimate Academy. It is now 10 p.m. Everyone is out now on work duty.
Bedtime, Ursine.
Bedtime already. Today really flew by too. As I lay in bed, Ryoma's words came back to me. Reason to live. When I really think about it, what do I have? I want to see my family and friends again, but is that a reason to live? What about continuing on Kaede's legacy? I wonder how it was for Kaede. I'm sure she had plenty of reasons to live. That's the kind of girl she was. But why am I thinking about this? I shouldn't be thinking about this stuff. I know I need to stop thinking that way, but when I'm alone, I can't help it.
Damn it.
With all my willpower, I forced myself to sleep. Oh?
Is he sleeping?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he's sleeping. He's out like a light.
Oh.
You mean out like a light?
More importantly...
Who cares? Just hurry up and leave the present so we can get out of here.
Don't rush me! Jeez, it's dark in here. I can't tell which is which!
What have you bears done?
College and Trix exams are a big milestone! fun part with finding a job or getting married. All you and Germanies out there working hard. When studying, focus is the most important. Boost your focus by throwing away all those comic books and video games. Oh, but Spiketoon Self games are fine. They're specifically made to improve your focus. And burn those pictures of your girlfriend. You don't have time to indulge in good memories. But be sure you don't burn your actual girlfriend, because you'll go to prison for that. Prison might help you focus, but then you won't be able to go to your exams. If you can't focus at all, it's also good to confine yourself somewhere and study. I recommend confining yourself in an enemy's base. The thrill of studying in a place where you might get caught does wonders for your focus. Oh, I also recommend studying in a disaster zone. The thrill of studying in a place where you can actually die does wonders for your focus. Oh, I also recommend studying in the middle of your exams. The thrill of knowing it's too late to get any studying done does wonders for your focus. With my advice, you'll beat the competition. So get out there and do your best.
Official announcement from the Ultimate Academy. It is now 8 a.m.
So
have a wonderful killing school semester today.
Wonderful announcement, Monodam. I can't believe this is your first time.
Hey,
this isn't really your first time, is it? Hey, is this really your first time?
This is my first time.
Oh, you're blushing. How cute.
More
anyway, we dropped some presents in your room.
And that's that.
Cover it in beer, cause Hella starts here.
So long, farewell.
A present? What does that mean? What is this? When did this get here? It looks like a model pad, but it's not. It says Cubs Pad on the back in fine print.
Huh?
Cubs pad. When I touched the screen, the device came to life and started playing a video. Kato Mamuda's motive video.
By popular demand, it's time for the motive video!
Wait, what? Wait, Kato Mamuda. Why is it Kato? Oh! Did they switch up mine and Kaito's?
Who's the most important person in your life? And now, without further ado,
Kaito
Momota, the ultimate astronaut. Thanks to his exceptional talent, this young man is already an astronaut trainee. Wow, our team has managed to score an exclusive interview with his grandparents. They miss their grandson terribly, and hope he returns to them safe and sound. But don't just take my word for it. Let's hear it straight from the source.
Kaito, as long as you're alive, I don't need anything else.
No matter what happens, you must live. You must never give up. Please, live on, for our sakes too.
Their only wish is for Kaito to live. Will Kaito be able to fulfill his grandparents' wish? Ah yes, one more thing. Shortly after this interview wrapped, these old farts suffered an unfortunate accident. What kind of accident? It's a secret! Find out for yourself!
Onikuma, what have you done? What? What was that? A motive video. Could this be another one of Monokuma's motives? Even if it were, why do I have Kaito's motive? Ah, I'll think about that later. I should hurry and tell Kaido. I ran out the hallway on a mission to find Kaido. I should try Kaido's room first. With shaking hands, I pressed the doorbell. No answer. Did he already leave? In that case, he must be at the dining hall. I'll try there. Well, this is... Oh, Kibo, let's start with you. Did you get something?
Kibo!
Kibo, have you seen Kai...
Shinichi!
Impeccable timing, Shinichi! I was on my way to get you!
Huh?
You were.
Please!
Everyone is gathering in the dining hall! Please come right away! I'll go get everyone else. Everyone, is this about the videos? I should go to the dining hall. Kaido must be there. Alright, let's go to the dining hall. Kaido's not here either. Hey, has anyone seen Kaido?
You see him in a panic. Over the cop's bed, if I'm not mistaken.
Huh?
What?
You're not the only person who got one, Shuichi. We all did.
Yes.
We've all been given motive videos. However, they have been mixed up.
Huh?
Mixed up?
When I woke up, there was a cop's pad in my room, but the video on it wasn't even mine.
Samugi, we should discuss this once everyone is here.
Huh? Oh, sorry. You're right.
What do you mean, once everyone is here?
Yes.
Kaido and Kibo went to gather everyone else so we may discuss our plans.
Yes.
Shall we wait for everyone then? Until then, I can provide you all with massages.
Way to ruin it, everyone else. Thank you all for waiting. We have gathered everyone else.
Oh, dear.
My word. And I was finally about to experience one of Kurumi's famed massages.
What is it?
What do you mean? Are you also suggesting that I cannot read the air?
Well...
So what is it? What did you drag us here for?
Come on, man.
Didn't I tell you? It's about the Cubs pads. Monokuma gave us a new motive. We can't not talk about it!
Is that so?
That thing looks... that looks like another monopad. That was the motive.
Huh?
Maki! Haven't you watched the video on the cop's pad yet?
Okay.
No. I ignored it because I figured it was something stupid.
That's actually really courageous in a weird sort of way.
Let me guess. Maki has mine.
Alright!
You don't have to speak up! But this is important, so you should at least listen.
So,
what are these videos?
No doubt they're more motives for Monokuma, but why were they all mixed up?
Honest.
Yeah. Why Gonta get Tsumugi's video?
Hey!
No, don't say it, Gonta.
Huh?
I heard it. I see. So Gonta has my video.
What happened?
Huh? Gonta not supposed to say it.
Yeah.
Who? Fucking guess! We're gonna exchange them anyway, right?
No.
No, we cannot exchange them. What? We can't.
Why?
Why not? They're videos of the most important people in our lives.
No.
And that is precisely why we cannot exchange them.
Listen closely.
Although we do not know why our murders were mixed up, as long as we don't exchange them, we don't have to see our motives at all.
Then
it's better to just ignore them.
Yes.
Yes, at least that's what I think.
Mm-hmm.
That's true! If we ignore them, then we won't have a motive!
I'm against it.
Why?
Huh? Against it? Why? If you see that video, it'll turn into a motive, right?
That's why I want to see it.
You do?
Always messing around.
You were saying something like that before, that you don't plan on surviving. It might not matter to you whether you get killed or not, but we're different. We all want to live. Wake up already. You're like some zombie wandering around with no will to live. No will to live, huh? If that's how you see me, then so be it.
Not cool.
But I've got no plans to change my opinion. That's just not cool.
What?
What did you say?
Who cares? Ryoma just stated his opinion.
Because?
Actually, I feel the same way as him.
Kokichi.
Are you trying to cause trouble again?
That's so mean.
Don't get the wrong idea. I'm not saying we shouldn't care about killing or dying. But I think it'd be better if we didn't cooperate with each other. Actually, we definitely shouldn't cooperate with each other.
Why?
We shouldn't cooperate! Why not?
Because?
Think back to all of Monokuma's actions so far. Whenever we tried to work together, Monokuma would retaliate with a plan to make us suffer. It happened when Kaede wanted to cooperate, and again with these motive videos, right? Which means, the more we try to cooperate, the more he'll try to make us suffer.
Then.
You are saying that if we do not rally together, we will not be made to suffer?
I'm disappointed.
That's why I had no choice but to screw with you guys, but you ingrates didn't even notice.
That's...
And you're not lying to us right now.
Now you know.
Whether I'm lying or not, what I'm saying is still true.
You know?
Anyway, we shouldn't force ourselves to cooperate. Let's just all do our own thing. So I agree with Ryoma's suggestion. It's because we're trying to cooperate that Monokuma is making us suffer. But what about everything we went through? What was the point of Kaede sacrificing herself?
So that means...
Anyway, I'm warning you for all of your sake. Let's just exchange our motive videos instead of cooperating with each other.
Incomprehensible.
I cannot comprehend that logic.
See?
Well, now that I've said I won't cooperate, I can't afford to be seen with you losers. Come on, Gunter, let's go.
Huh?
Oh, what? Gunter, too?
Because?
We promised we'd think of a way to get everyone to exchange their motive videos, remember?
So that means...
Anyways, Kurumi, I'll hit you up later when I'm feeling hungry.
Wait! Did Gunter make promise?
Actually...
Why can't you tell when he's lying, Gunter?
Yeah. Quit screwing around! Our sake! Yeah, right! I've had it with his lies!
Well...
So are we done here? Then I'm leaving. Kurumi, bring me my dinner later.
Hey.
I'm heading out, too.
Alright!
Wait up, Ryoma! Don't forget, we're all struggling to get out of here alive! So don't get in our way!
Jeez.
I've got no intention of getting in your way. I'd never do something so uncool.
By the way...
Kurumi, could I get you to clean my room later?
Actually...
You guys are relying on Kurumi too much.
I do not agree.
I do not mind. Serving others is the true desire of any maid.
Huh.
You shouldn't spoil people, though. Especially degenerate males.
In any event...
Our cooperation is the number one factor in our suffering, isn't it? Kidding. I wonder, will this turn out? I will observe with great interest.
I shall observe.
Oh, and Kurumi. I shall have you record my observations. I trust you to do it properly.
Aw, poor Kurumi.
Well,
I'm certainly not gonna hang out with a bunch of chumps like you.
That
being said.
Guess I'll go back, take a shit, and get some sleep. Kurumi, pick up an invention for me. Okay.
Wow. How much is everyone going to depend on Kurumi?
That is troubling.
My workload has increased significantly. This calls for more tactical approach.
Come on, you can't spoil them! They'll just turn into ungrateful leeches!
Huh?
Wait, what's wrong, Himiko? Are you hungry?
What?
Then how about we eat together? Kurumi, one tripod pot? Hot pot, please.
Tenko, you're only giving her more work.
Himiko?
What's the matter, Himiko? You don't like tripod pot?
You don't get it, Tenko. Himiko isn't hungry. I know, because I have the almighty Atua.
Whatever, let's just enjoy some tripod pot.
Jeez,
you're so careless, Tenko.
In the end, those of us who stayed behind had tripe hot pot for a quirky take on breakfast. I have no idea what the food is. We also promised not to show each other the motives. Oh, too much breakfast. Anyway, it seems like everyone wants to do their own thing. What can we do to work better together as a group? I wish I could do something on my own, but that's impossible. If I screw up, it'll just be like Kaede all over again.
It's no use.
I did it again. I can't keep these thoughts out of my head. I can't stand around here doing nothing. I promised her. More free time! Wrong button. Okay, so let's look at the gifts and who we can... Wrong button! Who we can give what to. Because I really kind of want to talk with, Kurumi. The maid, but I don't know what we would give it. What we would give her. What would we give... Flame Thunder, a broom that lets mages fly high speed. When they sit on it, it's a little bent, but it can also be used for cleaning. So maybe we give Kurumi this. Wheelchair of Doom, we already know who that would go to. Three-layered lunchbox. Maybe. I'm not sure who that one would go to. We tried the bird shield, so we already know who the sketchbook and art can go to. Upbeat humidifier, great for gloomy people, but to cheerful people, it's just a paperweight. Pillow of admiration, a pillow that helps you sleep while it gives you wonderful dreams. However, the dreams will serve an entire lifetime, making you feel intensely empty after you wake up. Yeah, so that would go for the race toy block, which would probably go for the caretaker. Marigold seeds, not sure. Perfect blanket. Ice machine. Alright, I'm going to try giving that room to, what does cleaning like? Cleaning. And none of these really give her... None of the food really do anything of that sort. So, let's save. Let's go find Kurumi. Kurumi is in her room. Alright. Let's see if Kurumi will take the broom thing. Up this Kurumi. Awesome. Let's read Kibo's thing. He's equipped with many functions you would have expected an ultimate robot to have, but some of them are certainly strange. Kibo is proud of his combat lightweight design, but I don't quite understand. Okay. So let's see. Kurumi! Did you have a request for me? I am scheduled to assist Mew with her invention. I can fulfill your request afterward, provided you do not mind waiting, of course. Could I hang out with Prime for a while?
Yes.
Yes, I should rest for a bit before I help her with the invention. Kurumi and I took a break together. Kurumi and I grew a little closer today. Would you like to give Kurumi a present? Definitely! Let's give her the flame bundler. I never told you I needed this, but is it truly alright for me to have this?
Thank you.
Thank you. This will help me immensely. If I can use this, I can help everyone as well.
How can I help
you? Suichi, how can I help you?
Huh?
Help me.
I will grant you.
Give me any command. I will do anything for you.
I don't really have anything to ask of you at the moment.
How?
Why did you talk to me then? Well, I was thinking we could spend some time together. Is that alright?
I do not agree.
No, not at all. If that is what you wish, then I shall wait by your side forever. So please do not hesitate and request anything. It's not like I wanted you to wait on me. I just wanted to be with you a while. That is a rather vague request. What do you wish for me to do?
No.
I already told you, I don't wish for you to do anything.
How?
Why did you call for me then?
Yeah.
Alright, how about this? Let's talk about something.
Understood.
Would you like me to keep you... Would you like me to serve you by keeping you company?
Huh?
Serve?
Do you agree?
Is that not what you wish for? No, that isn't quite... what should I say? Kurumi is a maid, so perhaps this is why she's so insistent about this. But this way, I'm gonna suffocate. Kurumi is being too serious.
Hey,
Kurumi. Didn't you chat with your classmates during lunch breaks or after school?
Yes.
I had, somewhat. Why do you ask?
Remember.
Well, because I want to spend time with you in that way. For example, perhaps we could drink some tea in the dining hall.
That is fine.
Yes, that is fine. Then let us go to the dining hall. Good, she seems to understand. Forget about Mew. Mew's got plenty of inventions. Suichi, what would you like to drink? Tea or coffee?
That's true.
Tea, I suppose.
Understood.
I will go and prepare it. Please wait. Wait, Kurumi.
Too late. She's already in the kitchen.
I didn't mean to make her prepare tea all by herself. Apologies for making you wait. It is done.
Kurumi returned, pushing a cart. One that cart was... Whoa! What is all of this?
Yes.
It is your afternoon tea.
Well, I can see that, but I'm noticing something so extravagant. It's so extravagant, we can't even put it in pictures. There were delectable sandwiches, cakes, and scones lined up on the cart. And the tea smelled so wonderful, it put all the other teas I ever had to shame. She prepared all this in just minutes? Is this the power of the ultimate maid?
Please,
Suichi, please sit here.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you. I sat down, but noticed Kurumi standing still, with perfect posture as always. Kurumi? Kurumi, are you going to sit? But if I sit as well, then I cannot serve you.
No.
I don't want you to serve me. Just come and sit with me.
Please, go
I prepared
ahead.
This just for you, so please.
But...
May I?
Suichi, you commanded me to prepare you tea.
I will do
and I intend to complete any request given. Please enjoy this tea. I'm Mr. Meeseeks, please look at me. Okay. Kurumi's report card has been updated. We should be able to do one more. Kurumi waited on me hand and foot, and then I returned to my room. The tea, the sandwiches, the scones, the cakes, they were all excellent. There's still some time left. I can't sit around and do nothing. Alright, let's
save now that we've done treatment. So let's see. Of the presents, I'm not sure who we could do what to. Could do the cosplayer. Definitely do the cosplayer. Or we could go with Kokichi. Cause I'd be kind of focused on the girl. Let's go with Kokichi. Let's go with Kokichi. Where is Kokichi? Kokichi is here in the second floor building. Okay. So I need to go to the second floor. Go. He's in the classroom. Alright, let's hang out with the evil guy. I want to see if I can go and try to go into Maki's ultimate research lab. I want to see if I can try at least to get in there. Let's look at the map and find out where is she first. Yep, Maki's at her room and stuff. She probably wouldn't let me go, but let's try it before we go back to Kokichi. Nope, she's in front of her room. There is no way I'm going to be able to get through there. Alright, let's go back. I didn't read Kurumi's, thing. A genuine maid who takes every word as an order. She makes wonderful tea and her abilities are endless. Okay. That was short. Okay. Let's run. Get some extra model coins. Even though honestly we won't really get any model coins. We get way more model coins by going through the trials. Kokichi, let's chat with you. Don't you think it's strange that we're keeping each other's murder videos? I can't stand this corruption. Should I hang out with Kokichi? Yes! Huh? With me? I don't mind, but what about Gata? If that is what Soichi wanted to, then Gonta step aside like gentlemen. Okay, let's take Gonta's offer then. I spent some time with Kokichi. Kokichi and I grew a little closer today. Would you like to give Kokichi a present? Definitely. I want to give him the evil... The work chair of doom! The ultimate workstation with a comfy chair and so much technology you'll never want to get up. Those who sit here will be in danger of becoming obese. Actually, I'm not sure if that actually goes for him, though. That seemed like it might be something for me. I know we had something else that would go right for him, but I'm not... What was it? Chico, beautiful. Let's go to the workout chair.
I guess this isn't bad.
You have pretty good taste, Suichi.
Well, not as good as mine. I'll surprise you with a gift one of these days, Suichi.
Suichi!
Oh, cool, it worked. So, you want to talk to me, eh, Suichi? You must be pretty reckless, huh, Suichi? I'm the ultimate supreme leader, you know. So you say, but does that really mean anything? And what is this organization you run? Please speak directly into the microphone.
Huh?
Didn't I tell you? I'm the supreme leader of a secret evil organization. Yes, you've said that, but...
Yeah.
It's pretty impressive, too. It has over 10,000 members.
But...
You've said that as well, but I can't think of any organization that fits that description. didn't I tell you? I'm also a liar too, you know.
Okay.
Yes, you've mentioned it multiple times.
It's true!
But I'm telling the truth when I say I'm the supreme leader of an evil, secret or evil organization.
I get dizzy talking to Kikichi. I feel like I forget how words work.
My organization controls the entire world, but of course it's behind the scenes. All the world's mafia syndicates are under my control. They'll get into turf wars if I don't control them, and that's just trouble for everyone. It's a pain, especially since peace is the best thing for the world. I don't think I can believe the words of the leader of an evil organization. Oh yeah, which is why I do the same thing with the government too. I control politicians with blackmail. I manipulate the stock market on a whim. I support independents all over the world. The White House, Kremlin, Beijing, Wall Street, London, and even the Tokyo Stock Exchange.
You know?
I make one phone call and the world changes. Let me know if you get bored with the world.
That has to be a lie. How did you rise to the top or all your subordinates coming for you? How did you rise to the top?
Well, I killed my parents and inherited the organization.
Huh?
You what? You killed?
It's a lie.
Don't worry, I'm lying.
Okay.
I see.
It's true!
I only killed my older brother.
Huh?
What? I'm lying about that too. How he rose in power is top secret. I'd have competition if you copied me.
Suichi!
So, now that you know about us, Suichi, you must die!
Wait!
What? You told me! I didn't even ask!
You got me!
Oh yeah! Oopsie poopsie! I'm such a ditz. Then I'll let you live for now, since I messed up, but I'll kill you eventually. Are you serious?
Yeah,
for realsies. I hate lies and jokes. Just kidding, I lied again. Hey, the report card's been updated.
I returned to my room, mind and body exhausted. Why am I so tired just from talking? He said he would kill me. He's just lying. Right? Why do you have a knife? Right?
Ooh.
So usually you get 4 free times.
Ding dong, bing bong.
Auto come,
it is
continue.
Now nighttime.
This is an official announcement from the Ultimate Academy. It is now 10 p.m.
So?
The late night special in the exclusive Auto Camp Kitchen in the dining hall is...
I'm whipping up a rice bowl with chicken, egg, and spicy kimchi. It's only 1,000 calories.
It's easy to make. Just put fried chicken in a laser press, top it with kimchi. Oh, and don't forget the mayo.
You know, actually, that does kind of look good. Not gonna lie. That face.
By the way, this here's for my cups only.
We ain't sharing any with you.
Bam! How do you like my culinary chaos?
So long, farewell.
What is that button on their mouth supposed to be for anyway? I wouldn't eat that greasy food even if they threatened to kill me.
But
anyway, nighttime already, huh? When it gets to be nighttime, I start thinking about things. Was there really no way to save Kaede? I ask myself questions like that. Because no matter how I think about it, what happened to her is my fault. Huh? Is someone here? The doorbell's ringing. And we will answer that next time on Danganronpa. So, first I'm going to read from Kikichi. The supreme leader of an evil organization with 10,000 members. He claims he can change the world with a single phone call. He offers information without being asked, and then threatens to kill you because you know too much. Alright, so we're going to save and leave that there for tomorrow. Same time as always. 5:30 to 7 tomorrow here at this channel. Thank you everybody so much for watching. Goodbye and have a good one.